It's time for our daily devotion. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Cristuto Genobaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 12, 2020. John 3 verses 3 to 8. Verse 3. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. For Nicodemus saith unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb, and be born? 5 Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. 6 That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. 7 Marvel not that I said unto thee, Ye must be born again. 8 The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh, and whither it goeth, so is every one that is born of the Spirit.
Quotation from the Spirit of Prophecy. Nicodemus himself had felt that there was a lack of spirituality among the Jews, that, to a great degree, they were controlled by bigotry and worldly ambition. He had hoped for a better state of things at the Messiah's coming. Yet the heart-searching message of the Baptist had failed to work in him conviction of sin. He was a strict Pharisee, and prided himself on his good works. He was widely esteemed for his benevolence and his liberality in sustaining the temple service, and he felt secure of the favor of God. He was startled at the thought of a kingdom too pure for him to see in his present state. He felt that he needed no change. Hence his surprise at the Savior's words. He was irritated by their close application to himself. The pride of the Pharisee was struggling against the honest desire of the seeker after truth. He wondered that Christ should speak to him as he did, not respecting his position as ruler in Israel. Surprised out of his self-possession, he answered Christ in words full of irony, How can a man be born when he is old? Like many others, when cutting truth is brought home to the conscience, he revealed the fact that the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God. But the Savior did not meet argument with argument. Not through controversy and discussion is the soul enlightened. We must look and live. Nicodemus received the lesson, and carried it with him. He searched the scriptures in a new way, not for the discussion of a theory, but in order to receive life for the soul. He began to see the kingdom of heaven as he submitted himself to the leading of the Holy Spirit. By Ellen G. White, Desire of Ages, pages 171 to 175.
Our prayer for today. Dear God, our Father in heaven, it is with utmost humility and with awe and reverence that we approach your sacred presence because you are our Creator, the great God, and most lovingly, you are our Father. Thank you for the message today of our need to experience a spiritual new birth through water baptism by being immersed into the water. As we reflect on our baptismal experience, help us to renew our spiritual personal vows to God today. Thank you for answering our prayer because we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.